ice here. Those damn builders are supposed to have finished this doorway by now. I say, Smallbridge has got some nice pieces in there.
Yeah, well, you've got some nice junk in here.
Antiques are what you sell. Junk is what you buy. And I've got some very nice pieces here myself. Here, take this Georgian candlestick, for instance. It's a fine piece. If it is then the one. Now, if that were one of a pair, be worth a bob or two. Well, this is where I work. This is where the brain work is done.
Ah. Oh, it doesn't get used a lot, does it?
David, I want to talk to you about, reproduction.
Oh, yes, I've told you before, Dad, I'm not interested in antiques.
I'm not talking about antiques, I'm talking about the human race.
Ah, got you.
Mm. Well, don't you think it's about time that you and Lynn, produced?
Ah, look, Dad, I'd like to oblige you, but, I can't.
Can't?
Do you remember when we had our cat and you took him to the vet?
Yes.
Well, I'm the same.
What do you mean you've got worms?
No, Dad. I mean, I've had the operation. Look, Dad, I've got a confession to make.
Confess, my son.
Yes, look, I misled you the other day. I haven't had the operation. All right, I'm perfectly all right, physically. No.
Did you hear that, Oliver?
No.
The line is not fizzled out.
Oh, that's marvellous. Is Lynn expecting then?
Well, no, she's not, but she could be in about an hour, though. See you.
Oh, I say, look at that. Your clever old father's got himself an interview on the local radio talking about antiques. Well, I knew it was only a matter of time.
To be broadcast on the 14th, live from your shop. But they've asked you because of your worldwide reputation as an antiquarian.
But of course. The producer of this program is obviously a student of the arts, a critic of discernment.
Yes, and a member of your golf club.
Is he? I didn't know that.
Yes, Fenwick, didn't you get him into the club the same day he applied?
Did I? I didn't know that.
When there was a 5-year waiting list?
Yes, well, I was always against that.
Yes, so was Lynn's dad, I gather.
Well, Smallbridge is against everything.
Yes, flashing the old school tie, he calls it.
My dear David, everybody has an old school tie to flash. Even Smallbridge. And you can't see his because he's holding his trousers up. Here she is, the little mother-to-be herself.
Mother-to-be what?
How did the checkup go?
Fine.
And you'll be delighted to hear that for the sake of family unity, your father and I are doing the broadcast together.
Oh, I see. Family unity.
Yeah, and in the light of your good news, you know.
Good news?
You shouldn't start knitting little booties if you want to keep it a secret. We are hoping for a boy.
But no, you've got it all wrong.
All wrong? What do you mean?
Yeah, but there's no baby there. No, it's, more sort of there, really.
Well, enjoy your drinks. We must be off to bed.
In bed? It's only 9:30. I'm not tired.
Well, stay and have a drink with us.
Yes, I don't know why I said that. I'm tired. God, I'm tired.
You can stay up, darling, if you'd like to.
No, I'm tired. I'm really tired.
Yes, all that hard work you've been doing lately, David, you get your beauty sleep, boy.
Have you gone round that bend? I mean, they think it's you that's having the baby and not Glad.
Shh! Does it matter? You can see how happy they are.
I think I'm going balmy. I really think I'm on the way.
It's only till that wretched interview is over. I can always say afterwards it was a false alarm. Oh. Don't you dare say a word.
Say anything? It'll be sign language very soon. Dad, I wanted to talk to you.
Sounds ominous. Give yourself a drink.
Oh, no, it's about your drinking.
My drinking?
Well, your lifestyle in general, but yes, I do think you are getting a drink problem.
Oh, no, Dave. No. I can assure you I've got no drink problem at all.
Really?
I can drink anybody under the table you care to name.
Yes, I'm being serious, Dad. Look, I'm worried about your health. You should think of giving up a few things.
My health?
Yes.
Yes, you're perfectly right, David. I mean, for my health, I'd be prepared to give up anything.
No, you would.
Except food, drink, and sex. A balance has to be struck, David, between a long and boring life and a short and happy one.
Yeah, well, that's all very well, but I've been reading this book, and I'm very worried about your cardiovascular system. It says here...
I don't know what my cardiovascular system is, but if it doesn't like a decent meal and a drop or two of malt whiskey every now and again and a touch of the other, I don't want to know.
Why do you keep going on about sex? It's only the rich food and the booze I'm worried about. Sex is actually beneficial, according to...